Here on the campus of the University of Cincinnati, where today the UC Bearcats are trying to keep their very perfect 2017 going as they face the East Carolina Pirates. You saw the tip-off. We are just getting going. Along with Maria Fantana-Rosa, I'm Betsy Ross. We are so glad to have you here for this American Athletic Conference game. We'll talk a little bit about the starters and everything in just a minute, but Maria, just want you to kind of set the scene. What are some of the keys that we need to be watching in this game?
Well, these are two great teams right now, Betsy, so we're in for a great ball game. But as you can see, they're pressing, and that is going to be a huge key for UC to make sure that they keep the defensive pressure in the full court and then the half court. Also for UC, they want to play an up-tempo game. Great rim run right there by East Carolina. For East Carolina, they have to continue to get those points in the paint, and they have to take care of the ball.
And we just saw that quick two underneath for the Pirates. Pirates leading early 2-0 in this game. Pirates have some height advantage again. Of course, UC does run small, so anytime you face somebody that's 6'2 or 6'0 or 6'1, it's going to be tough for UC to get underneath. Last time out, UC faced some very tall trees at SMU, and they were able to use their defense to get back at them. As you see right there, Chelsea Warren goes inside, and she gets the two to even this up. Pressure here right in front of us by UC. UC's defense is very good, but the outside shot, boy, it falls. You can see Ture out there. She hits almost 40% from outside three, so she can have that outside shot all day. One player that you want to watch here, again, is Chelsea Warren goes inside. She is called for the travel. But for UC, watch number 21 is one person that you'll want to watch on that. 21 is Shanice Johnson. She is the leading scorer for UC, and she's one to watch. For East Carolina, they've got some big scorers as well. Kristen Gaffney, she leads them in everything. A transfer from Vanderbilt. She averages more than 14 points a game. She leads them in rebound and steals. But UC now back on the offense as UC Johnson now taking control as UC sets up their offense here.
Both teams right now are doing a great job of attacking on offense and setting each other up. UC is definitely making a great focus right now to set big screens, and it's giving them high percentage shots. They just need to continue to take care of the ball.
Inside, the layup doesn't go, but Gaffney fights for the rebound. That doesn't go. Chelsea Warren brings it down for UC. Loses the handle, gets it right back.
We're seeing a quick tempo right now, Betsy, but I think both coaches right now would rather that just because it's getting the early adrenaline out for both teams. Anna Owens right now has had three nice setups already of her teammates as the point guard and obviously takes to the basket like she just did right there. Anna's only 7 points away from her 1,000, and as we mentioned before, Betsy, I hope she gets it quick so she could focus on other things because it is always the pink elephant in the room.
Exactly. The reverse layup by Owens doesn't go, so East Carolina back on the offense. Looking inside, McDonald will take it. McDonald gets it from the free throw line, and now the Pirates have extended that lead to 7-2 now with 7 minutes left in this first quarter.
McDonald, a key player for them. She's obviously a transfer from West Virginia, but she could drive and has great middle game.
Outside for three, Shanice Johnson. It doesn't go, and Gaffney brings it down. Little backcourt pressure there by Quisenberry, but East Carolina is able to bring it up here on the front court. East Carolina getting ready to substitute, and so is UC here in just a little bit. Inside to Gaffney again. That height really pays off. Doesn't fall, though, and Quisenberry now starts the break for UC. Looking inside, she'll stop, pops. Yes! Gets it to go. Bianca Quisenberry tightens up that game now. It's 7-4 now. Bearcats trying to creep back here as the Pirates broke out to that early lead. Baseline, that doesn't go. Gaffney had the ball go right through her fingers. Quisenberry again stops off the glass. Quisenberry trying to bring the Bearcats back single-handedly, and she's almost done it. 7-6 now, the Pirates still lead.
Quisenberry's been the hot hand right now for UC in conference play. She's shooting 40% from the three and really a coach on the court. She does so many smart things, whether it's on offense, defense, and sets her teammates up as well.
And she's a senior. You really like to have that senior leadership as well.
Dominique Keaton hitting a short jump shot.
Inside, Warren, no. Quisenberry again. That one doesn't go, though. McDonald brings it down for East Carolina. Oh, quick foul there. Anna Owens didn't mean to bump into her, but she did. So Anna Owens gets called for the foul. A couple of substitutions very quickly for East Carolina. Holston comes in. And for UC, Antoinette Miller, one of the freshmen. We'll be talking a lot of these freshmen for UC. Antoinette Miller comes in now for the Bearcats.
And Coach Macy likes to sub a lot in the first quarter. She goes 10 deep a lot and likes to figure out her chemistry by who's playing well in the first quarter.
Heather Macy, by the way, in her seventh season at East Carolina. The turnover real quick, and that goes back to the Bearcats. 10-9, the Pirates are overall, 1-5 in conference, but they have had a very, very tough early conference schedule. That record may not be indicative of the kind of team that they really are. As Warren gets it off glass, Bearcats now down by one.
Both teams right now being patient, getting inside touches to create opportunities outside, good ball movement.
Gaffney stays outside, the three doesn't go. Shanice Johnson brings down the rebound. We'll call Shanice Johnson's name quite a bit. Not only is she the leading scorer, but she is top on that defense. And she goes in with that layup. Bearcats take their first lead now, 10-9. 4:25 in the first.
Shanice is explosive. As you know, I love watching her play right now. She creates so many things. And they're double-teaming her. They're focused on where Johnson is, and she's still splitting defenders.
McDonald stops just inside the arc, and that one doesn't go, and Johnson brings down that rebound. Antoinette Miller looking to go inside, tosses it back out to Anna Owens. To Johnson. Johnson all by herself with the layup. It doesn't go. I think she was almost too open. Sometimes that happens.
And she split three defenders to get herself open, so creating opportunities for herself as well as her teammates.
McDonald's layup doesn't go. The fight for the ball. There's Miller with a nice move inside.
And once again, wanting to run up-tempo for UC definitely plays into their strength.
And we have a break. 3:39 left in this first quarter. The Bearcats leading 10-9 here on the American Digital Network.
For every hero, there is an origin story. An experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling. Offering a different kind of education. One guided by distinguished professors who understand experience as the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations. We commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
And welcome back here to Fifth Third Arena here on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. Just getting going between the Bearcats and the Pirates. And UC leads by 1 point right now, 10-9. One of the players that you had mentioned that we really want to keep an eye on is Kristen Gaffney. And she, as we mentioned, leads this team in just about every stat so far.
On a positive note, Betsy, they are looking for her. She's had three shot attempts already. She does all her work before she gets the ball, running the court, moving on offense. You saw her take that open three. She's 0 for 3 right now, but she has the potential. She's scoring 14.6 points a game right now and grabbing 6 rebounds. But this is a player that could explode at any time. And when I talked to Coach Macy, it's important to her that she dominates, wanting the ball every time. And her words were, she needs to demand the ball every possession. And as you notice right now, when she doesn't touch the ball in the possession, their shots are not as high percentage.
And we've seen her shoot inside and outside as well. She only shoots about 25% from the arc, but she wasn't afraid to take one from the arc when she was wide open. So she won't hesitate. If she thinks she has some space out there in the outside, she'll take it.
Yeah, that's a great comment, Betsy, because she's shooting 53% right now from the field. And that's obviously, she's not just scoring all the time just inside, which obviously is a very impressive statistic.
Back in action, it is still UC's basketball. Quisenberry getting ready to trigger it in. Looking for somebody, looking for Miller. Shanice Johnson. Oh, and they said the Shanice Johnson tipped at the last, so it's a turnover. It goes over to East Carolina. So East Carolina making a substitution there during that break. Antoinette Bannister, who just triggered it inside. She comes in. 5'10 senior guard, transfer from Florida. And we'll talk a little bit about the transfers that they depend upon here at East Carolina. That outside shot goes by Bannister.
Great patience again, finding the shooter.
And there's inside. That's another player that came in during the break, Angel Reiser. She gets that layup, and we are tied at 12. Angel Reiser is another one of these freshmen that Jamel Elliott really depends upon to come in during the game. Wide open inside. There's your inside shot by Gaffney. She was open.
And she found the opening after they trapped in the zone right now to get herself wide open and finished.
Inside to Johnson. Johnson has it tipped away, and they say once again she tips it last, so another turnover as East Carolina makes another switch. Number 15 comes in for East Carolina. Tyus Oliveira now comes in for the Pirates.
That was a great ball screen and roll right there. Shanice Johnson set a huge screen and then her rim run. She's going to hit those shots, Betsy. That was great execution on a two-man game.
East Carolina now being a little more deliberate. You were talking about the tempo. They're being a little more patient now. I think you're right. Way outside. That doesn't go. Bannister was open, though. She took it, but it was a little too long. Inside, Miller with the layup. Nope. They say she traveled, so it doesn't count.
Once again, those are the turnovers that, as coaches, you don't tell the team you like, but you do like that they're aggressive turnovers. Now, right now, UC already has four turnovers, which is a little uncharacteristic of them.
Terry almost took that outside shot. She didn't. She'll take it now. Torre doesn't go. Fight for the rebound. Johnson gets it. Shot's too short, though. Anna Owens brings it down. Anna thought about going inside. Instead, she pulls out. Quisenberry is able.
And once again, another great ball screen up at the top right now, recognizing what East Carolina is doing on defense and continuing to attack.
20, Bree McDonald, and 23, Dominique Claytor. A couple of the starters, they come back in now for East Carolina. And you touched on that early, that Heather Macy is not afraid to switch out and put basically her whole bench in this game. Outside for three, doesn't go for Owens. Pulled down by Bannister as East Carolina now goes back on offense.
UC has definitely closed Miller's right in Bannister's face right now in the zone. They've matched up. They know that she's a great off-the-pass three-point shooter. She has the most attempts on their team this year coming into this game. She's at 89 attempts, shooting 32% from the three. So you saw UC make that defensive adjustment and get out on her, causing the turnover with their one dribble game.
You see Reiser came out for the Bearcats, and the starter, Chelsea Warren, comes back in. Another whistle.
And once again, changing up defenses. Great coaches in the American Athletic Conference. This is a chess match again against each other. Coach Macy just went to a 2-3 zone, but she brought both her guards out to trap, creating a different tempo than UC wants to run right now in the half court.
That foul, by the way, was on McDonald. Inside, Chelsea Warren tried to lay up, but again, drew the foul.
And really, UC has had success when they've gotten to the free throw line. A high percentage shooting team. I know when I talked to Coach Jeff Lanier before the game, it's his scout, and we talked about how important free throws were because they make them to get to the line. The secret goal, I guess, is 20 attempts right now. So I think they're well on their way to do that with the up-tempo, with attacking in the paint. And once again, they're good free throw shooters, shooting a high percentage. This is a great way for UC to score on the half court.
Justice G comes in for the first time. Also coming back to the floor, Kristen Gaffney. Now for East Carolina.
UC back in their zone, matching up right now. Good talk, good shifts.
Taking their time, Gaffney gets the ball. She's looking inside, nothing there, so she pulls it back out. 5 seconds on the shot clock. A little too strong. Anna Owens brings it back down. She starts this fast break. On the baseline, that one doesn't go, but again, Miller is able to draw the foul.
Once again, another great setup by Anna Owens. She's controlling this game right now with her attack in transition, and that was a great setup for an easy jumper for Miller, but obviously the game plan is to attack the paint, and once again, they get to the free throw line.
And Miller usually is one of the outside shooters, but as we said, because they depend so much, the Bearcats do, on those freshmen. She comes in only 43% from the line, but as a team, UC shoots 73%. They've got some pretty good free throw shooters on their team as Antoinette Miller makes the second one, and we are tied once again as we get ready to wrap up this first quarter. We are tied at 14. Nice steal there by the Bearcats as they have another chance to take the lead before we end this first quarter.
Once again, Bianca Quisenberry taking her time. The shot clock differential is only 3 seconds, so they're being patient right now.
Tip away, Anna Owens, though, saves it. They get it back to Miller. Miller fakes the three, but Quisenberry will take it. Yes! Gets a three.
great patience right there by UC guards to make that one extra pass to get that open shot.
McDonald inside in the lane. Shot is off. It doesn't go. And Quisenberry's three-pointer gives the Bearcats the lead at the end of one. It's UC 17, East Carolina 14. We'll take a break here on the American Digital Network.
2017 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship tickets are now on sale from our start through the 7th at the Beacon Sun Arena. Get your tickets today and watch all of the teams.
We are American. We are the Spark
NCAA Tournament. Tickets start at $99 and you can purchase online at thebeaconsun.com. On Ticketmaster, or call 1-800-733-3000.
Because on this court, it will stay on the energy of five becomes the power of one. That's power. We are power.
We are American. The conference of opportunity. The opportunity to chase dreams. The opportunity to make your mark and change the game. Because that's power. We are power.
The American Athletic Conference Championship is right around the corner, taking place March 9th through the 12th at the Excel Center in Hartford, Connecticut, as all 11 American teams will compete for the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Tickets are priced as low as $199. Get yours today online by visiting www.excelcenter.com, in person at the Excel Center box office, or by telephone at 877-522-8499. We look forward to seeing you in March. The 2017 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship tickets are now on sale from March 3rd through the 7th at Mohegan Sun Arena. Get your tickets today to watch all 11 teams in action fighting for an automatic berth to the NCAA tournament. Tickets start as low as $99 and can be purchased online at MoheganSun.com, on Ticketmaster, or by calling 1-800-743-3000. Let the games begin. We'll see you in March.
And welcome back to Fifth Third Arena here on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. We are just getting ready to start the second quarter, and the Bearcats leading the Pirates right now, 17-14. Maria, after the first quarter, what do you see? What jumps out at you?
Well, the field goal percentage is a huge difference right now, Betsy. UC shooting 50%, getting high percentage shots right now, attacking the paint and getting to the free throw line. East Carolina right now, they're only shooting 31%. So UC's defense and adjusting in the zone right now and matching up on the shooters, causing turnovers, is creating problem for Eastern Carolina's offense.
Nice pass inside. Miller is able to convert. And all of a sudden, the Bearcats have stretched out that lead now to their biggest lead, 19-14, as we open up this second half. Gaffney was out for several minutes there in the first quarter as she takes that three. That one doesn't go. Fight for the rebound. Goes out of bounds. I think they're going to say that Carolina touched it last. But right now we have an injured player there on the sidelines as Frazier was going out to try to get that loose ball. And UC bench kind of jumped out of the way, and she probably hit one of those chairs that are there at the side. So the staffs are over there looking at her right now. As they work on Frazier, let's take a quick break right now. We are 9:23 into the second quarter. Bearcats leading 19-14.
For every hero, there is an origin story, an experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling, offering a different kind of education, one guided by distinguished professors who understand experience is the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
And we are back here as they resume to action. Frazier was able to walk over there to the side of the bench, and Torrey came in for her. You saw that quick basket underneath by East Carolina as they're closing the gap now, 19-16, the Bearcats lead. Johnson's outside, makes a little spin move there in the lane. Can't find anything, but they call Brandi Tarver for the walk right there. So another turnover by UC, and it goes right back to East Carolina. You know, we talked about how good and how important Gaffney is, and she sat out quite a bit there in that first quarter, but you said that they are not afraid to switch personnel, especially early in the game for East Carolina.
They do switch a lot, but she's a key for them. Great passer. She demands the respect of the defense right now, and when East Carolina looks good on offense, they're getting touches to her, and the offense is run through her.
Outside to Tarver again, inside to Anna Owens. Anna stops in the lane. That one's a little too strong. Johnson, though, nice fight for the rebound. Bearcats keep possession. Anna Owens, as we mentioned, she has 7 points from 1,000 mark. Inside to Chelsea Warren, doesn't go, though. And that's one of the problems with, you know, not a real tall inside game for UC. Those inside passes, they can get tipped away pretty easily.
And that was a good look. Just the timing, it was a little slow before Shanice passed it to her. About a second off, but she makes up for it on the defensive end.
Nice pick there by Johnson. Johnson going inside again, the tip away. And they say the East Carolina touched it less. It will still be Bearcats basketball as East Carolina makes yet another switch as Claydor comes in now for East Carolina. You know, we talked about so many transfers. Holston is from Georgia Tech, Bannister from Florida, Gaffney from Vanderbilt, Bree McDonald from West Virginia, Oliveira from Florida College. I mean, a lot of transfers, but they're all making really important contributions to this East Carolina team.
They are, and she graduated a lot. She graduated 56 of her 64 points last year, including two all-conference players.
Outside for Johnson, she gets it to go. 21-16 now, the Bearcats lead.
She needs to figure it out. They are double and tripling her on the drive, so she's finding different ways to score right now.
Torrey from outside. That one's a little too strong. There's Gaffney inside, though. She's got the height, and she can pick up the rebound.
She just does a great job, Betsy, of positioning herself when she does not have the ball to put herself in a position to score. That was a great weak side rebound.
Spin move, and they call the travel on Johnson on that one. It was a nice move, but they say that she shuffled. So East Carolina making yet another switch as Frazier. She was the injured player. Frazier's able to come back into the game, so it's nice to be able to see her come back into this game for East Carolina. She brings the basketball up. Little token pressure here in the backcourt. It works enough for Anna Owens. Anna, inside, layup. No, too strong. Fight for the rebound. And who do they say touched it last? It was a little bit of a scrum there. It looks like East Carolina touched it last. So it's going to be Bearcat basketball. Nice defense there. We have seen that a couple of three times now. A tip away, a loose ball. Johnson has snared a couple of passes. They really depend on their defense to get that offense going.
They are, and it's controlling the tempo and staying in their favor. Now, in the half court, East Carolina is doing a great job of double and triple teaming Shanice Johnson. Now, she's a smart player. She's taking outside shots. Still, her strength is to drive, so she's going to continue to do that. But I like what this coaching staff is doing. They're having her set the ball screen, so help has to leave her for a second to open her up so she can score in different ways.
Miller stops, a little too strong. Nobody else was underneath, so East Carolina gets that rebound. McDonald now going against Shanice Johnson.
And UC right now is getting good wide-open looks. They just have to finish. Great take by Gaffney, though, once again showing her versatility, all that she can do. Shoot the three, take to the basket, post up.
Inside, Quisenberry doesn't go, but again, she draws the foul. There's that strategy that you talked about, is making sure if you don't get the basket, at least draw the foul. If you do get the basket, it's a bonus.
Absolutely.
Here's another look at it.
And a shooting foul, so obviously going to the line. Now, they've only been to the free throw line four times right now, but as we know with the new rules of the game, what's happening is that when you get to five fouls in each quarter, they get to shoot two. So from 6 minutes on now until halftime, both teams are starting to get a little tired. You could see continuing to change up their defense to have the created turnover attack in transition. And once again, it's paying off with high percentage shots and drawing fouls to get to the line.
As we talked about UC being a pretty good free throw shooting team, Quisenberry shoots 85% from the line. So,
yeah, she's money from there. In conference play, it's even higher from the free throw line.
Outside, a little too strong. Quisenberry brings that one down. She starts the fast break. Pulls up, nothing inside, so she pulls up as Johnson now slows things down. Brandi Tarver came in during that free throw, so Tarver is now on the offense for UC. Quisenberry stops, a little too strong. Gaffney brings it down for East Carolina.
Once again, the Pirates are trying to control this tempo right now. Good ball movement. Coach Macy setting plays. You saw the diagonal lob when we came back from break to attack the weak side forward in the zone. That last play was a flare screen for Bannister. But somebody has to shoot the ball, and there you go. Now, hopefully, with Toure hitting that three-pointer, it'll change the offensive mindset right now for the Pirates.
And Toure was all by herself, too. UC even forgot about her, or they were not anywhere close. Johnson takes it inside. Nothing. The tip away, they're going to call that a foul.
Yeah, absolutely. And once again, another great ball screen by Shanice, but she just didn't. She didn't make her rim run, or she didn't move after it, the screen and open, because they're definitely focusing on her being the screener and then looking to get her another touch, whether it's to be a scorer or obviously to set up her teammates.
Gaffney comes out of the game. Oliveira comes back in for East Carolina. Fresh 30 for UC as they set up their offense. With Anna Owens out, it's really up to Quisenberry now to be the quarterback there on the team. Inside to Warren. Warren, double team, spin move. Yes, off glass.
Great high-low look. Once again, an inside touch. High percentage shot for UC.
UC now back up by four, 25-21.
And you can see the
Toure
defense
looking for a little space underneath. They're going to call that one on Brandi Tarver there on the baseline. No, they called an offensive foul as we take a break here. We are 4:29 into the second quarter. The Bearcats leading at 25-21 here on the American Digital Network.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations, we commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
For every hero, there is an origin story. An experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling. Offering a different kind of education, one guided by distinguished professors who understand experience is the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations. We commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
Welcome back to Fifth Third Arena, along with Maria Fantana-Rosa. I'm Betsy Wallace, as UC Bearcats are leading East Carolina Pirates right now, 25-21, 4:29 left in this first half. What have you seen so far in this second quarter, Maria, that maybe is different that both teams now are trying to adjust?
Well, both coaches right now are changing up their defenses. the Pirates right now, they're very focused on individual tendencies right now. It's very obvious with how they're playing Shanice Johnson right now. They know that that offense goes through her, and they're very focused on her. They're also changing up right now when they're extending. They went to that zone where they tried to trap just to get UC out of an easy momentum tempo on offense. For UC right now, we're seeing extended presses. We're seeing half-court traps. We're seeing zones. We're seeing man. So they're really trying to keep East Carolina on their heels, and they're very focused on where Gaffney is. The zone shifts to where she is because she's a player that continues to move without the ball to put herself in position for easy scoring opportunities.
Both teams are needing to cut down on those turnovers. Both teams have 8 turnovers. Well, that was a good three-pointer by Bannister off the glass, and she gets it to go from the corner. And now Bearcats lead by only 1 point. Anna Owens back in the game now for UC. Quisenberry looked to take that outside shot. Oh, bounced it right off of Johnson. Johnson was not watching for the ball. Bounced it right off her. Ow. And it looks like Holston, she was going to take the shot. She stopped. Boy, you hate to see that.
Absolutely.
Grabbing her leg like that. I mean, she wasn't even touched either. She was just making the move there in the inside on the underneath the basket. And she stops, and once again, the East Carolina crew is out there taking another look at her. While they work on Holston, let's take another break now. 4:07 left in this second quarter. Bearcats lead 25-24.
For every hero, there is an origin story. An experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling. Offering a different kind of education. One guided by distinguished professors who understand experience is the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations, we commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
And we are back here at Fifth Third Arena. You can see Gabby Holston's being helped off the floor now. She really wasn't touched underneath the basket. But they are helping her now. They're just going to take her right back to the locker room area. She favors that right leg. Hate to see that happen.
And unfortunately, this team has overcome a lot. You've got a lot of new players. They had an injury last week. Now this other injury. And that was a great minute for East Carolina. Momentum started to go their way. Bannister banking the three. But you could see on their faces right now that that took a little bit out of them. So hopefully they'll respond.
That's tough. Shanice Johnson, Anna Owens now. Here's Quisenberry. Quisenberry double-teamed there in the corner, so they get it back to Owens. Brandi Tarver in the lane. She'll take it from the line. A little too strong. Doesn't go. East Carolina now with the momentum. You're right. And they have an opportunity to take the lead again, down only by one.
And the defense right now has created a lot of opportunities going both way. The Pirates defense looked totally different since we came back from break right now. That's a different intensity. And UC, obviously, not finishing. Look at that trap, though, by UC. Now, that's obviously Coach Elliott trying to change up the momentum again, but obviously it's a foul, so it works to ECU's favor.
Bannister's not afraid to take it. She goes inside this time. And they say that UC touched it last. Chelsea Warren, they say, touched it last. So it goes right back to East Carolina with 20 seconds on the shot clock. Now we're going to talk about it. Yes, they still say the East Carolina touched it last. So 20 seconds on the shot clock. They look to trigger their offense. Inside to Bannister. Nothing there. Fight for the rebound. Clater gets it. Doesn't go. They tip it out of bounds. And they always have this long discussion of who touched it last.
Coach Macy on the court right now to get a timeout.
Yep. Heather Macy takes that timeout as we get ready for the rest of this second quarter. 3:23 left. There you can see the inside shot and the tip away.
Once again, a great take to the basket. High percentage shots right now attacking the paint, but they need them to fall right now.
So what do you think really made that difference in the momentum besides, of course, hitting a big basket? That helped a lot for East Carolina, but it seems as if UC has been thrown out of their rhythm a little bit
they
now.
They have, and that defensive pressure by the Pirates, that's totally made UC tentative right now. Their defense is tentative right now. Offensively, you saw the movement out there. They're looking for each other to step up. So they're tentative right now.
Goes back to East Carolina, looking to trigger it in. They finally get it inside. Layup doesn't go, and another whistle. And they called this one on East Carolina.
Brandi Tarver, she is a great defender. I mean, if you watch her, she shuts people down. I mean, she turns things for UC with her defensive athleticism.
By the way, that foul was on Kristen Gaffney, her first. And Brandi Tarver, she's not one of their big scorers, but, yeah, she starts every game, and it's mainly because of her defense. And now we're back on offense. Now 3 minutes to go in this first half. Anna Owens, as we mentioned, 7 points away from that magical 1,000. And ever since she's gotten really close to 1,000, you're right, she has had off games. She hasn't scored yet at all in this game. And that is kind of the thing that hangs over the players. You know, you want her to get that 1,000 as we take a look at Shanice Johnson going inside, and Claytor is getting called for that foul as Johnson goes to the free throw line.
And that was one of the few times that she wasn't double teamed on an attack to the basket off penetration. And once again, the free throw attempts, as we've mentioned, works to UC's favor. High percentage shots. They're getting a break by stopping the clock right now. This last 3 minutes could dictate how the rest of the game goes right now.
76% she shoots from the line as Bree McDonald came in for East Carolina in that game. And for UC, Tanisha Coleman getting her first action here. 27-24 now. Bearcats lead. We're under the three-minute mark now as East Carolina. Torrey's taking charge of the offense now. Inside splits the defense. Doesn't go, but Torrey gets her shot back. McDonald will stop, and she gets it to fall off glass.
And those are the possessions that, as a coach, did a great job extending, but then they don't finish the defensive stop.
Johnson now looking to get inside. Johnson takes it inside. It rolls around and falls for him. Nice move inside by Shanice Johnson.
And right now, you see back in their zone right now, pointing out where the shooters are. Good shifts right now, but being safe. And East Carolina right now is attacking differently. Backdoor cut right there.
Yep.
They've looked to penetrate. They're not settling for outside shots. It's a big adjustment by Coach Macy.
Nice give and go there as Bannister gets it inside. Back to being a one-point game. We got about a minute and a half left in this first half. Anna Owens trying to get something going with her offense. Nothing yet. Almost had it tipped away, so she'll pull it back out as UC resets that offense with 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Inside, Chelsea Warren, yes! Nice layup there by Warren. She shook loose, and the Bearcats extended. 31-28 now. With just a little over 1 minute to go in this first half. Johnson being guarded outside. There's Gaffney. Gaffney with Coleman on her. Double team, doesn't go. Johnson has it fall into her lap. She starts the break. Anna Owens doesn't take it. She's looking for somebody to get it. Chelsea Warren gets it now. She's triple teamed, so it goes back outside to Anna Owens. A little smile on Anna's face going, I was looking for somebody. Owens spins, nothing. Shanice Johnson, she goes inside. She'll stop, a little too strong. Torrey now brings it up for East Carolina. We're 30 seconds left in this one. Bearcats still with a 3-point lead. Torrey slows it down. over to McDonald. Seven on the shot clock. They got to decide to do something here pretty soon. Inside to Johnson. She takes it. Doesn't go. Quisenberry with 6 seconds left. Quisenberry starts the break. Inside, tries the layup. Doesn't go. Follows her shot. Yes! At the buzzer, Quisenberry fought for that rebound, and she got her shot to go. We are at the end of one right now, and the Bearcats have pulled away here at the end, and they lead the East Carolina Pirates 33-28 as Quisenberry ends this first half with 10 points. She is leading all scorers right now, and she really had to fight for those last couple of buckets, but she got them to go. The Bearcats are leading now 33-28, and Maria Fantanarosa is with Bearcats coach Jamel Elliott.
Coach, your defense changing it up is creating a lot of opportunity, not only in the half court, but in the full court, keeping them confident. How do you continue to keep this momentum going your way?
Well, we want to continue to change it up, but, you know, we're giving them some free cutters down the lane. I would like us to rotate on the backside, help a little better, so we don't give up those easy layups. But we knew it was going to be a battle. You know, they came in here ready to play. We did, too. So looking forward to a good second half.
Your offense right now, you're doing a great job of using Shanice in different ways, setting screens, finding different ways to get her open. You're also doing a great job getting to the free throw line. What other opportunities do you need to set your team up to score offensively in the half court easier?
Well, they're changing it up too. You know, they're going some man, some zone. So we just got to call something and run it all the way through. You can't try to change it in the middle of the play. We just got to stay with the play. We have really good ball movement, good spacing. We got guys looking at the rim. No matter what offense we run, I think we could be successful.
Thanks, Coach. Good luck.
Thank you.
Thank you, Coach, and thank you, Maria. By the way, when you see leads at the half, they are 9-1 so far this year. We will set for the second half and take a break as the Bearcats lead 33-28 here on the American Digital Network.
The American Digital Network studio with an all-new episode of The Rise. Thanks for tuning in. We have a full show in store for you today. The college football season ended last week with a national championship in Tampa, but fans of the American can still follow some of their favorite players through the NFL playoffs, as this weekend's AFC and NFC championship games are stocked with players from American Athletic Conference schools. The NFC championship between the Green Bay Packers and Atlanta Falcons could be particularly interesting to fans of East Carolina, as Green Bay rookie cornerback Josh Hawkins could find himself lined up against his former college teammate Justin Hardy of the Falcons. Hardy has taken on a greater role in the Falcons' potent passing game in recent weeks and had 4 touchdown receptions in his second year in the league, while Hawkins has stepped into the defensive backfield rotation in Green Bay, seeing action in the Packers' dime package last Sunday against the Dallas Cowboys. Hardy is not the only receiver making an impact for the Falcons. Former SMU standout Aldrick Robinson had a breakout regular season with over 300 yards and 2 touchdowns. Former UConn wideout Nick Williams and cornerback Bleedy Ray Wilson are both on the active roster as well and hope to get into the lineup Sunday against the Packers. In the AFC Championship, there should be no fewer than 7 players from American schools taking the field. The Pittsburgh Steelers have former Cincinnati defensive end Ricardo Matthews and former Temple linebacker Tyler Matakevich in the regular rotation on defense, while on offense they have veteran running back D'Angelo Williams from Memphis and rookie wide receiver Demarcus Ayers from Houston. The Patriots have also benefited from the play of a rookie from Houston, as linebacker Elandon Roberts has become a fixture on the New England defense. Roberts joins veteran kicker Steven Goskowski from Memphis and long snapper Joe Cardona of Navy on a past team that is playing in its 6th straight AFC championship. While we root on American alums that are living out their dreams in the NFL playoffs, a lot to talk about as conference play continues to heat up on the hardwood. Several games came down to the final possession this past week, including Tulsa's last-second thriller at Temple. Sterling Taplin's layup with 4 seconds to play lifted the Golden Hurricane to its 2nd straight win and elevated Taplin to American Player of the Week honors. Cincinnati extended its winning streak to 8 games with 2 wins last week, including a thriller against an SMU team receiving votes in the national polls. The Bearcats knocked off both SMU and East Carolina behind the front court duo of Gary Clark and Kyle Washington. Clark had 18 points versus the Mustangs, while Washington tallied his 6th double-double of the year against the Pirates. On Wednesday, the number 20 Bearcats will try and tie their longest home court winning streak under Mick Cronin when they host Temple. UC will be gunning for its 19th straight home win in a rematch of both teams' conference opener. Not to be outdone, SMU owns a 15-game home court winning streak at Moody Coliseum and will put it on the line against UConn on Thursday night. The Ponies will then welcome Houston to Moody on Saturday in a key conference and intrastate showdown. Two of the winningest coaches in NCAA history will meet on Thursday as well. Tubby Smith and Kelvin Sampson have a combined 1,118 victories between them, with Smith holding a slight edge, 570 to 548. The pair have known each other for over 5 decades, and the respect the two have for one another runs deep. Smith is one of 2 coaches to have guided 5 different programs to the NCAA tournament, while Sampson has taken 3 programs to the big dance himself.
We are American. We are the spark that ignites. Dazzling, brilliant, intense. We are plugged in with the volume turned up all the way. Because on this court, on any given night, the energy of 5 becomes the power of 1. That's power. We are power.
We are American. The conference of opportunity. The opportunity to chase dreams. The opportunity to make your mark and change the game. Because that's power. We are power.
The American Athletic Conference Championship is right around the corner, taking place March 9th through the 12th at the Excel Center in Hartford, Connecticut, as all 11 American teams will compete for the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Tickets are priced as low as $199. Get yours today online by visiting www.excelcenter.com, in person at the Excel Center box office, or by telephone at 877-522-8499. We look forward to seeing you in March. 2017 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship tickets are now on sale for March 3rd through the 7th at Mohegan Sun Arena. Get your tickets today to watch all 11 teams in action fighting for an automatic berth to the NCAA tournament. Tickets start as low as $99 and can be purchased online at MohiganSun.com, on Ticketmaster, or by calling 1-800-743-3000. Let the games begin. We'll see you in March.
Well, we have three standards in our basketball program, which are discipline, hard work, and exceeding expectations. And we feel like that we have a blueprint of what it takes to be successful at ECU, but those are the three staples for sure. Well, the price of admission to be involved in our program from a player or coach standpoint is hard work, and there's nothing in between it. And so every day, that's a combination of what we do each and every day, and it's a big event. The kids look forward to it. It's got some numbered different runs that they do, but it is also in the middle of all that being able to answer what our team standards are or what our core values are. Well, I like the returners that we have. They were the ones that were really pushing those kids who are now pros a season ago. And so then you look at that we have the highest ranked recruiting class for freshmen that we've ever had. We're 48th in the country. And so those kids we're looking at for them to come in and be incredibly successful and play immediately.
I felt they gave me the correct tools to be equipped to be able to lead a team, so now I'm ready to step into that role and see what I can do for what they did for me as a freshman, do it for my freshman this year. You got to be in the gym to get better. You have to always stay on top of everything, whether that's watching film, getting in the gym, putting shots up, or even just working on your conditioning. Personally, just want to make sure our team is where we need to be. We want to definitely finish better than we did last year, but for the season overall, we want to make it to the Sweet 16, if not further.
Nothing works unless you do. And so the ability to get in the gym, create a disciplined routine. This group is definitely a workman-like attitude about them. And so my hope is that when you see really good kids working really, really hard, they'll see the success and results from it.
We are American. We are the spark that ignites. Dazzling, brilliant, intense. We are plugged in with the volume turned up all the way. Because on this court, on any given night, the energy of five becomes the power of one. That's power. We are power.
We are American. The Conference of Opportunity. The opportunity to chase dreams. The opportunity to make your mark and change the game. Because that's power. We are power.
The American Athletic Conference Championship is right around the corner, taking place March 9th through the 12th at the Excel Center in Hartford, Connecticut, as all 11 American teams will compete for the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Tickets are priced as low as $199. Get yours today online by visiting www.excelcenter.com, in person at the Excel Center box office, or by telephone at 8.
Welcome back to Fifth Third Arena here on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. We're at the break. Bearcats leading 33-28 over the Pirates. We have Maria Fantanarosa with East Carolina's coach, Heather Macy.
Coach, you did a great job defensively midway through the second quarter. What offensive adjustments do you need to help win the game?
Well, we got 39 shots. You got to feel good about that. One, we've got to shoot a high percentage. Two, we've got to get to the free throw line.
Well, good luck, coach.
Heather Macy in her seventh season at East Carolina. She is second, by the way, in the all-time list at that school for wins. She is 11 short of being the all-time wins leader from the school. As we get ready to start the second half, let's take a look at some of the action early in this first half as UC had a deficit early, but then they came back. Here's East Carolina working the inside game. There's McDonald. She was all open inside, but then UC coming back. Chelsea Warren with the inside move. There's McDonald again. She stops from the outside. East Carolina had the lead early, but then UC was able to come back in that second half. The outside shot, it goes there, but UC can shoot it from outside as well. McDonald very active in this first half. Shanice Johnson, keep your eyes on her. She has been a star both on offense and defense. The inside pass there to Chelsea Warren, and Chelsea is able to convert in that. Gaffney, as we mentioned, she comes in here as the leading scorer for East Carolina, but Maria, right now Gaffney only has 4 points, and she's been sitting out quite a bit here in this game. McDonald has a very good game so far in this one. She has 6 points as UC starts on the offense, but right away there's a turnover. UC had 10 turnovers in that first half. They need to cut that down. Terrae tries the reverse layup, doesn't go. So UC gets the ball right back as they try to hold on to this lead.
And right now you could see right now that the Pirates defense right now is a different level of intensity. And I'm sure that's been a focus for their coaching staff.
Anna Owens stops. That was not even close. The fight inside, they call a jump ball.
And once again, that defensive pressure, that ball pressure, the great rebound there on the weak side. Right now, East Carolina has definitely picked it up, and it's changed the momentum going the Pirates' way.
East Carolina now on the offense. Frazier directing the traffic. Frazier, you might remember, came out a little bit early in that first quarter for injury, but she's right back and gets it to go off the glass. So it's a 3-point lead now for UC as UC tries to get that momentum back.
Yeah, and that was a great move by Alex Frazier. UC playing soft right now, and they're taking it to them.
Anna Owens quiet so far in this game. She hasn't gotten anything to fall so far. She's usually very good in the outside shot, but she hasn't had an opportunity. Another tie up here. Jump ball. This time it'll go the Bearcats' way, but they only have 8 seconds left on their shot clock.
And once again, a defensive adjustment by their staff to trap that ball screen.
Owens gets it over to Johnson. Brandi Tarver, that shot is a little too short. East Carolina pulls down the rebound. Looking inside to Gaffney. There she gets back into the offense. Nice turnaround move there.
Yeah, she's a great scorer. The more touches that she could get, the more opportunities they're going to have to win on the offensive end.
Anna Owens has her layup try blocked. East Carolina pulls it down again. East Carolina's looking very good just in the first couple of minutes. That shot's a little off by Torre. So it's Johnson now. Inside, she goes against Plater, and she gets it to go.
Both teams up-tempo, but both teams very controlled, well-coached, taking high percentage shots, and knowing when to slow it down.
McDonald, nobody's on her, so she'll take it. Why not? It goes.
McDonald's been fun to watch right now. She just has every aspect of her offensive game, very confident, giving them sparks when they need it.
And we're tied now, all of a sudden, at 35 with 7.5 minutes left in this third period. Johnson will take it from outside, gets it from the arc.
And Shanice Johnson right now is just... She's unbelievable. I mean, the things that she could do on the offensive end, defensive end.
Torrey kind of throws it up there. Really wasn't aiming too much. I think she was hoping for the foul and didn't get it. So you see now back on the offense, Anna Owen slows it down as they try to look inside. Chelsea Warren being guarded very tightly. Fight for the rebound, fight for the loose ball, and this time it's a jump ball that will go East Carolina's way as East Carolina makes a couple of more substitutions, as well as Miller coming in for UC. But both of these teams have been substituting really without abandon in this one. Both teams really have to be pretty fresh because they have been able to substitute, use most of their bench in this game.
And both teams right now have been doing a great job of keeping it an up-tempo game and then changing it to a controlled tempo game when needed. And that's where you need the fresh bodies.
The tip away, Shanice Johnson once again, good defense, gets the tip to Ida Owens. Ida finally on the board.
The turnovers that have led to easy points right now for UC has been why they've been playing well offensively.
Bearcats now stringing that lead back out to 5. Gaffney inside, double teamed inside, little too short, fight for the rebound. There's Johnson again. Boy, she has really come up big in these first 4 minutes here.
UC's doing a good job of pushing the ball up the court, but you have to give the Pirates credit. They're in transition defense. They're getting back. They're communicating. They're not giving UC easy looks when they get back.
Frazier now take it all by herself. She was not very much contested there. She was able to get into the lane and get that layup.
Betsy, we're talking about the pace of this game. This has been an up-tempo game both ways right now. Even though they're going deep to their bench right now, these kids are winded right now. They're playing hard on defense, using a lot of energy. But this style of play, this up-tempo right now, the better conditioned team is going to win.
Ida will take it. That's a 2 just inside the arc. But now that she's had 1 or 2 go, that might get her into the flow of the game a little bit more.
It might right now because ECU let her take that shot right now. They're inviting that, and she made them pay for it on that possession.
Gaffney's looking to go inside. Chelsea Warren guarding her. Once again, it's a pickup there by Johnson. The kick away. East Carolina picks it up now. Bannister. She'll stop from the line. That doesn't go. Tip out of bounds. They say that UC touched it last. It'll stay with East Carolina. And again, you can see that East Carolina is not wasting time. They bring in 3. You know, it's kind of like a hockey line. They're just trading lines here. But they are getting a lot of people involved in it. As we take a break now, we have 4:57 left in this third quarter. Bearcats lead 42-37 on the American Digital Network.
For every hero, there is an origin story, an experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling, offering a different kind of education, one guided by distinguished professors who understand experience as the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations. We commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
Well, We're back here at Fifth Third Arena on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. Let's take a look at our conference standings. Of course, UConn remains perfect. Temple remains perfect in conference play. University of Cincinnati, they only have one conference loss. That was to SMU. They're standing at 4-1 right there with USF. And ECU, 1-5, but that's really not indicative to what kind of game they've been playing because they have had a tough opening conference schedule. So that may not reflect the kind of team that they have.
Absolutely, and they've been in the games, Betsy, so they're competing with everyone right now. And when you talk about this rebuild, even though they obviously have some transfers that have experience, she's still trying to replace 56 out of 64 points from last year, and they're doing a phenomenal job. When you talk about this conference and how well-respected they are nationally, you look at East Carolina right now, and you look at their RPI. They're 80th right now. So throw records aside right now, this is a very talented ball team who is only going to get better and better each game.
Well, and you said that when you were talking to Coach Macy earlier, and we had mentioned that they play a lot of their roster. They played all 11 players in 10 of their last 13 games. And really, when we get down to crunch time, Coach Macy will basically take her best five and will put them out on the floor for that fourth quarter.
She will, and she sticks to three things that she recruits with, that she lives by. It's the discipline, hardworking, and exceeding expectations. And this team is doing that right now.
Gaffney had the handle, and she loses it, but East Carolina keeps it. Frazier, though, is called for the walk, so it goes right back to UC.
Once again, another touch inside for Gaffney that once again does continue. If she doesn't score, it creates good things because UC is collapsing on her, and it's opening up opportunities outside.
Miller is in the game now for UC as she's directing the traffic. Quisenberry gets the pick there from Johnson, and Johnson gets it right back. Johnson in the lane, uncontested.
And once again, a great job by Coach Elliott right now, having Shanice set ball screens and then get the ball back to be able to create for herself. So they worry about the ball screen, she gets the ball back, and then she has rip and take opportunities from the middle. And then you see on this end of the court right now, the trap trying to change momentum again with their defense created an uncomfortable situation for the Pirates.
McDonald comes back in, also Bannister for East Carolina. Looking to trigger it in, finally, Teray had it, and they said that she touched it last. Anna Owens contested that toss in, and it paid off. Bearcats get the ball.
And I've been impressed with UC's defense underneath. Their out-of-bounds defense has been phenomenal all game.
Bearcats holding on to that 44-37 lead halfway through this third period. Johnson looking for some room. She goes back inside. She's double-teamed. They're going to call her for the walk.
And there's your coaching adjustment right there. She's been ripping and taking from that right elbow, and you saw them sag in right there to help with the one pass away to help on that drive.
Some backcourt pressure now by the Bearcats. We haven't seen a whole lot of that. Not terribly sticky pressure, but enough to slow them down now. East Carolina looks to set up their offense. Touré now hands it over to G. In the corner, McDonald, she goes baseline, nothing there. Good defense there by Owens. Inside to Gaffney. Gaffney with the prayer, and she gets a layup.
Great
ball.
Finish, and she was being double-teamed at that point, Betsy, and she's still strong enough to finish.
Miller inside, and she gets it to fall.
And that's what they need to do, Betsy. They need to get start attacking the basket again to get back to the free throw line because, once again, that favors UC on offense.
Miller with 6 points there, and that foul goes against Touré. That's her second, so she'll come out real quick. I'll make a quick substitution, and Frazier comes right back in as Miller goes to the free throw line. So we said 43%. If you're a coach, you would like that percentage to go up a little bit. And it doesn't go.
When you talk about UC extending right now defensively, sometimes it's aggressive pressure like right now, and other times it's soft.
Oh, turnover, turnover, turnover. out of bounds. Who gets it? They call it a jump ball.
What that extended defense is doing right now is it's making the Pirates think. Can they go fast? Can they go slow? When are they going to be trapped? Great steal right there. Great scrappy play right there getting on the floor. You got to love it. But what it also does is when it's soft pressure right now, it takes 10 seconds off the shot clock. So the Pirates, who obviously are very well-coached, very patient in the half court, 10 seconds off the shot clock doesn't give them an opportunity to get it to the players that they're trying to set up. In that last play, it was Gaffney, and unfortunately she had 2 seconds to spare.
And one more quick substitution here as Torrey comes right back into the game as Anna Owens gets ready to trigger it in. There was a little bit of discussion with the referees of what the shot clock should be, and they put it back to 30, so they give the Bearcats a full 30 here as they set up their offense. Johnson outside shot. She'll take that all day. Bianca Grisenberry.
And that was huge right now. Once again, we talk about when you have to pay attention to where Shanice Johnson is, it makes your teammates more open. That was a good example of it.
Fight inside, and they're going to call a quick foul right there on the Bearcats. So Bearcats now with the 10-point lead. That's their biggest lead of the game so far, but that foul is going to go against Quisenberry. Quisenberry now with 13 points for the Bearcats. Inside to McDonald is... Johnson was guarding her, but she fell down, so McDonald had an open layup there.
Doing a good job using the screens right now, and it's probably because I complimented their out-of-bounds defense that happened right now. But I'm already a big fan of McDonald.
She has been a special player so far, 11 points for the Pirates. Fight for the ball, and they say that's going to be a foul on East Carolina. That's on Touré. And Torrey, that's her third. She came out with two, and so she's going to come. She's going to come out with three? No, they're going to leave her in for now. Another inbounds by the Bearcats. If they can figure out who's going to do it, there's Quisenberry. She better hurry. 5 second count. Here we go. There's Anna Owens. Pulls it back out, and she'll reset. Keep an eye on number 4, Angel Reiser, for the Bearcats, because she has a habit of getting loose underneath. There she is, making the turn. Nothing there. Three-pointer by Owens. Doesn't go. Boy, Gaffney had it, but nice snare there by Johnson. She takes it away, and she's able to draw a foul as well.
She does the big things, but she also does the little things like that, Betsy. She's so competitive right now. She plays to win every possession. That's Shanice Johnson.
And you're right. A lot of times that she will contest. She will get the big girl inside. And on her defense, she is able to sometimes change those shots just because of her defense. Those shots get altered because she has such sticky D inside. So, and that doesn't show up in the stats, but she's able to do that. And, of course, what she does on the offense is very impressive. There's Reiser. She gets loose, and she gets that layup. McDonald is able to get past Owens, and she stops for the easy five-footer. And there's Reiser again inside as she draws the foul. Angel Reiser just has this knack of getting underneath the basket.
Really, and Reiser right now, the things that you don't see is she's getting teammates open every time she sets the screen. She's taking a pride in that. So an unselfish player who obviously gets rewarded with a good breakaway rim run.
That foul is on Oliveira, and that's her third for East Carolina. Reiser gets the first one to go. And one more time, line change here for East Carolina as Gaffney comes back into the game, and so does Touré. Remember, Touré also has 3 fouls, so there's a couple players to watch, especially when we get close to the end of the game and we get into the free throw period of the basketball game. Reiser now with her second. And that one goes. And Bearcats are back to that 10-point lead with a minute 30 left in this third quarter.
And once again, just extended token pressure. Takes 8 seconds off the shot clock.
McDonald. That was almost a shot. She lost the handle. And they're going to call that one against UC. They were trying to get the charge, but they're going to call it as a block. That one was against Shanice Johnson. She's still down on the floor. She's holding her head, the back of her head. When she came down, she did come down on her head. So their staff will take a look, and we will take a break. 1:17 left in the third. The Bearcats lead 53-43.
For every hero, there is an origin story, an experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling, offering a different kind of education, one guided by distinguished professors who understand experience as the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
And welcome back to Fifth Third Arena. Shanice Johnson was able to walk off the court by herself. The inbounds by East Carolina. McDonald gets the easy layup and draws the foul as well. That one is going to be on Anna Owens, and that is her second as McDonald goes back to the line. And McDonald was one of the leading scorers in the last game that East Carolina played. She had 13 points in the loss to UCF the last time out. But McDonald has been really impressive. You're right. I've liked her game. She's quick. She gets inside. She shoots out and inside.
She does, and on that last play, she saw the cheat on the play and took advantage of a size matchup to be able to score.
Tip away there by McDonald as Quisenberry was going inside into the lane. So it goes out of bounds. Jamel Elliott's going to make another change here. She brings Brandi Tarver back in as Miller goes back out. Tarver with her defense. As Quisenberry gets ready to trigger the offense. Gets it to Tarver. She's looking inside. 8 seconds on the shot clock, so they have to make a decision pretty quickly. And loose ball, not a good clock management situation by UC. The loose ball, East Carolina, didn't matter because it was a shot clock violation anyway.
And you really have to give East Carolina's defense credit. They have picked up their ball pressure and their intensity. Now, the other side of that is, how does UC respond offensively without Shanice Johnson in there?
There's McDonald. She gets in the lane. Quisenberry gets the rebound. Just about a half second difference between the shot clock and the time clock here. So they've got a little time. They can play for one. Shanice Johnson, she is on the sideline. She's got an ice pack on her head. I'm sure that hurt coming down because you could hear her head hit. 9 on the shot clock now. Anna Owens goes in the lane, kind of shot, puts it up, and she gets it to fall. 1 second left. Gaffney inside. Are they going to count it? Yes, they do. They count it. So we are through three here at Fifth Third Arena. The Bearcats lead the Pirates 55-47. We'll be back with fourth quarter action here on the American Digital Network.
For every hero, there is an origin story, an experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling, offering a different kind of education, one guided by distinguished professors who understand experience as the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations. We commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
You can help us play the music.
Welcome back here to Fifth Third Arena, along with Maria Fantanarosa. I'm Betsy Ross. We're getting ready for fourth quarter action. Just looking at some of the awards here from the conference, the Player of the Week, Latska from USF, the forward there. other awards, the Freshman of the Week, Golden from Tulsa. The flashy guard there for the Tulsa team. And other honors for the week, the Honor Roll, Atkinson from Temple. Bree McDonald, we've talked about her all day today, how well she has been doing as well. Bree McDonald, by the way, was the leading scorer here. I think she still is. If we look at our stats, Bree McDonald now with 15 points. Yes, she is still the leading scorer. By the way, that last bucket, they have waved it off. They took another look at that, and they said they came too late. So we're back to a 10-point lead for UC, 55-45, as we get ready for this fourth quarter. What do you think is going to happen here for this fourth quarter? How do you see both teams adjusting, Maria?
Well, right now, both coaches defensively have been changing it up and really on the Pirates' end right now, just turning up their intensity, and their ball pressure right now is starting to create problems. Coach Elliott on that end for the Bearcats, she's been continuing to change up full and half-court pressure to keep them out of a rhythm right now. But defense, of course, should be why you win games. But, Betsy, right now, if Shanice does not come back in for the Bearcats, I think your primetime players are going to be the biggest key to victory on both sides. And, obviously, it's McDonald and Gaffney at one end. And hopefully it's Owens and Quisenberry on the other end.
Exactly. This is the big game for UC. They're looking for five straight. That's not going to help their cause, as now the lead's cut down to 8, 55-47 as we get ready here in the fourth quarter.
And once again, McDonald responds to being that big-time player.
She has been very impressive so far. So we said it's an important game for UC because 4-1 in the conference is the best conference start for Jamel Elliott. They're looking for their fifth straight. Brandi Tarver now with the ball. 5 seconds on the shot clock. Another shot put, and it goes. And Anna Owens gets it to go, and that puts her over the 1,000 mark for her career. She needed 7 going into this game. She's got 8 now, and she just needed a couple of them to fall. There's McDonald once again. She shakes herself loose there on the baseline.
Once again, the big-time players, they live for the fourth quarter. They want the ball in their hands, and then they finish, Betsy.
19 points now for McDonald.
East Carolina's doing a great job on that ball screen right now. A great hedge and making the guards of Cincinnati have to turn the corner.
And lane violation, it looks like, for UC. So there's another turnover for UC. And here comes Shanice Johnson. She's coming back in. So that's good to see that she's able to come back in. Turnovers, UC had 15 turnovers at the end of 3. So they need to cut down on the turnovers. But a lane violation gives the ball right back to East Carolina. Outside for 3, a little too strong. There's Quisenberry.
Once again, a well-executed set play by the Pirates to get that open look for the 3 right now.
Quisenberry uses the pick there by Johnson. Johnson now looking to go inside, but pulls it out instead. 10 seconds down the shot clock. Boy, UC is eating up a lot of clock trying to get a shot off, and that one gets tipped away. Another turnover by UC.
And once again, it's that ball pressure defense right there. Gaffney came and closed the trap, forcing the ball somewhere else. And who steps up at the Pirates' end but McDonald? Once again, excited to play in the fourth quarter. Big-time plays by her.
McDonald just gets wide open inside. She is able to shake her defender and just has the easy open bucket underneath.
Explosive first step, and she's finishing right now.
Anna Owens again. She's looking to go inside. And they're going to count it. It looks like they're counting it.
Yes. Great take, Betsy. Owens, great finish. Once again, now that she's gotten her 1,000th point, you know, she could relax right now and play to win this game.
Again, she just kind of tossed it up, and it goes, and she draws the foul as Owens now goes to the free throw line. Owen shoots 82% as well. As we said, overall, this team is a pretty good free throw shooting team. Anna Owens for one, and it falls. 60-51, Bearcats now string that lead back out to nine. Backcourt pressure. East Carolina able to break it pretty easily. Ms. Frazier now sets up her offense.
Great job taking care of the ball right now and still controlling the tempo that they could get touches to who their scorers are.
Gaffney was double-teamed, so they kicked it back out. Fight for the rebound. And they call East Carolina for the foul, so we're going to go the other way.
And Clater's having a great game right now. This freshman class, this recruiting class from 2015, was ranked by Dan Olson 48th best in the country right now. So they're potentially going to just get better and better. So I like that Clater's confident enough to take that shot in a situation like this where it's pressure shots.
Both teams depending a lot on their freshmen. There's the senior, Quisenberry. She stops on the baseline, doesn't go, but Shanice Johnson's able to bring it back down. UC gets a fresh 30 on the shot clock here as Anna Owens sets up her offense.
And once again, Shanice Johnson plays to win right there, all the little things.
The give and go goes right through Quisenberry's hand. Boy, they had the right idea, but just could not finish it off as Touré comes back in the game now for East Carolina.
Once again, you see extending right now, not wanting the Pirates to get into the half court and to be able to pick their shots.
McDonald in the corner for Gaffney, too strong. Big rebound there underneath, and McDonald one more time, 23 points.
What a great setup, though. Shot fake, dish underneath. But Bannister's got great floor vision. She can shoot the three. We've seen her takes to the basket, but great floor vision.
Johnson faked it. And they're going to call a timeout here as UC is Jamel Elliott saw something she didn't like. She makes sure that she gets her offense set up. And I think that that's something that we have seen for UC in the past. They've had big leads, and sometimes it goes away. So they have to really concentrate when they have this lead here in the fourth quarter.
And really right now, I think the timeout was to give Shanice Johnson a break. She's been in a very physical battle. They're double-teaming her right now. And they need her sharp at the end. So right now, for Coach Elliott, every offensive possession is so important. And when they extend, they're using a lot of energy on defense. So her just settling them down. Obviously, she called the full timeout. As you can see, they're sitting. So she's giving them a little break, probably giving them a little bit of a confidence, telling them how they're good, because they've been successful in the fourth quarter, in the end of game. That's when you look at their record right now, and especially in conference right now, they've been close, but they're confident enough that they finish games.
And for East Carolina, as we look at some of the upcoming broadcasts here, UCF will be the host as the Bearcats go down there next week. Also, it'll be Houston at Memphis. Tulane will be here with the Bearcats. You and I will be doing that game. And Memphis will be on the road at SMU. And we've seen what a tough team that SMU can be. So looking at East Carolina, they've got 6 minutes and 7 points to make up. So East Carolina, we know that their players are fresh because they keep changing their roster and lineups, and they just are always substituting. Gaffney has gotten plenty of rest. She's not even the high scorer now. It's been McDonald that's really shown up big here, especially in the second half. So East Carolina, what are they looking to do here in the last part of this fourth?
Well, she's got fresh bodies. She's definitely, her half-court defense right now has been very aggressive. The ball pressure, making it hard for UT to get open looks right now with the defense. And then on the offensive end, they're being patient. Gaffney gets touches, McDonald gets touches, and they're just being very patient in executing things, and they're getting high percentage shots on the offensive end.
You know, the scoring, not balanced at all, at least team-wise, East Carolina. As we said, McDonald's got 23 points. A couple other players, including Gaffney and Bannister, have 8. For UC, much more balanced. Shanice Johnson leading everybody with 15 points, and that's her average, 14 points per. Anna Owens finally getting on track in this second half. She has 11. And then Bianca Quisenberry really carried them in that first half. She has 14 points. So more balanced scoring there for the Bearcats. Chelsea Warren also with 9 points. As UC now 16 seconds on the shot clock as Miller back in the game, getting ready to trigger the offense.
Pirates showing the zone right now and trapping right away. Great job by Quisenberry to get out of that trap.
Quisenberry directing traffic. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Boy, they eat up way too much time.
Great.
Chelsea Warren inside.
Great coaching adjustment, Petsy, right now. ECU right now has been coming out and changing up, but they've been trapping and long hedging on that ball screen right now. And you saw the UC staff right there. They set a ball screen, isolation, and they slipped Chelsea Warren to the rim. So when the trap happened, they split it to give her an easy opportunity right now inside.
And the ball fake paid off. Oh, a little too short there on the free throw. Chelsea Warren hits 56% for the season. Warren with the second try here. Sophomore forward from Red Oak, Texas. Averages 4.7, so she is well over her average in double figures now with 10 points. Gaffney with the dribble, kicks it outside. Bannister, no. But Gaffney is there to pull down the rebound, still short, and it's Johnson that brings it in. Johnson with the fast break. And they pull it back out, setting it up. Miller was all by herself there for a second, but could not get the layup to go. Bounces off the rim, and East Carolina now with another chance.
And if you're both coaches right now, Gaffney touching the ball, setting up Bannister for a three, that's a high percentage shot for this team. On the other end right now, a rip and take layup by Miller, who's very explosive. That's a high percentage take right now. But it's the fourth quarter, Betsy. Who finishes? Gaffney. Kristen Gaffney stepping up again.
Gaffney with the layup. Now it's a six-point lead, down to a six-point lead. As you see, had a 10-point lead. Now East Carolina just keeps chipping away. Owens inside, Johnson outside for three.
Once again, your big players right now. Owens setting up Johnson right now for that three. That's a big time play.
The kick. And we are going to take another break here. Timeout on the court, 7:431 left in this game, and the Bearcats now leading 64-55 here on the American Digital Network.
We are American. We are the spark that ignites. Dazzling, brilliant, intense. We are plugged in with the volume turned up all the way. Because on this court, on any given night, the energy of five becomes the power of one. That's power. We are power.
We are America. The conference of opportunity. The opportunity to chase dreams. The opportunity to make your mark and change the game. Because that's power. We are power.
The American Athletic Conference Championship is right around the corner, taking place March 9th through the 12th at the Excel Center in Hartford, Connecticut, as all 11 American teams will compete for the automatic bid to the NCAA tournament. Tickets are priced as low as $199. Get yours today online by visiting www.excelcenter.com, in person at the Excel Center box office, or by telephone at 877-522-8499. We look forward to seeing you in March. ...2017 American Athletic Conference Women's Basketball Championship tickets are now on sale for March 3rd through the 7th at Mohegan Sun Arena. Get your tickets today to watch all 11 teams in action fighting for an automatic berth to the NCAA tournament. Tickets start as low as $99 and can be purchased online at MoheganSun.com, on Ticketmaster, or by calling 1-800-743-3000. Let the games begin. We'll see you in March.
Wow. Welcome back here to Fifth Third Arena on the campus of the University of Cincinnati. 4:31 left in this contest. Bearcats leading it 64-55. What jumps out at you, Maria?
Well, right now, it's going to be a defensive battle still, but we keep talking about the offensive players that continue to step up to make big plays, because at this point in the game, your better players want to finish.
East Carolina looking to snap a three-game losing streak as East Carolina sets up their offense. Toure looked inside, nothing there, so Frazier pulls it back out as they set up their offense with 10 seconds on the shot clock there. Pass inside to McDonald once again. She comes up big when they need her.
And that's her 25th point already, Betsy, and her career high this year, or her high for this year right now, was 22 points. So she's already having her best game of the year offensively. And look who she's guarding. That's a great matchup.
Johnson gives it to Quisenberry. Quisenberry looking inside. Again, they're using every second of that shot clock. Miller in the lane. Pretty move there. And Anna Owens now in the corner. I think maybe she just tripped. She's going to come out for just a second. Quick timeout there as Anna Owens goes to the bench, flexing that leg. You can see she's kind of taking a look at it, but don't know if she twisted an ankle or what, but she was there on the floor for a little bit. She's going to get a little bit of a rest here.
And you're right,
Beth. 3.5 minutes left in this game.
And Anna plays in conference. She's been averaging 38 minutes.
Johnson, the steal, the poke away, and the layup. Shanice Johnson, what she means to this team. Wow. It's been very impressive.
She's unbelievable. And as we talked about it, she's that big-time player that she plays every possession to win.
In the corner, Bannister, she'll take it from there all day. A little too long in that one. And East Carolina didn't even go for the rebound, so it's going to go right back to UC. As Shanice Johnson gets ready to trigger it in. What McDonald has done in this second half has really brought the Pirates back, but it's been Shanice Johnson who's really helped keep the Bearcats in front like she has. A little backcourt pressure here. McDonald on her. Miller gets it.
And really right now for UC, you could tell how poised they are right now. They're giving it to Quisenberry, their senior, controlling this tempo, especially with Anna Owens out right now. They're just very confident at the end of the game right now. They've had success in preseason and early conference right now, and they're playing to win.
The three-pointer way off by Quisenberry. She was by herself in the corner. It didn't go, though. Fight for the rebound. Loose ball. UC had it. And then it got away from Shanice Johnson. So it goes back to East Carolina. East Carolina's going to take a quick timeout here. And they're going to figure out what they want to do with this 30-second break. So they have 30 seconds to figure it out. So what do you do if you're East Carolina? You've got 9 points to make up here. So what's your next move? Especially on your offense, are you still going to depend on McDonald?
Well, she showed her hand a little bit. She's already extending right now. She can't let them sit in the half court and take 30 seconds to shoot right now, because that's definitely leading to UC's favor right now. Even though that last shot right now was an air ball, they're very patient and very confident at the end. They want them to think. The Pirates definitely want UC out of their confident rhythm. They don't want Shanice to be the one shooting at the end of this game. But right now, you know, all the momentum is going UC's way again because of Shanice Johnson and the things that she's doing right now. So right now, if you're the Pirates, she's probably giving them a dose right now of confidence right now. They played a great game. They definitely have big-time players right now, big-time scorers. McDonald's have a great game. Gaffney can do a lot of things. Bannister's back in. She's a great three-point shooter right now who's very confident. So they have a lot of offensive weapons that, even though there's 2.5 minutes left right now, and this looks like it's starting to be an 11-point, the Bearcats pulling away, this is plenty of time right now for their to play one possession at a time and get right back in this game.
Exactly. 68-57. I think I said 9-point lead. 11-point lead now for the Bearcats. The referees are over there. Looks like they're looking at the monitor.
So they readjusted the shot clock on that right now, giving them 25 seconds. It must have been a reset, but 25 seconds.
Whoa! Quisenberry with the kick, and it goes like way into the stands.
Some of the fans right now are showing me the three-point field goal sign. Notice I called it a three-point sign for the basketball fans out there, but that she kicked that field goal.
A lot of football teams would like to have that.
Absolutely.
Kind of
the Bengals being in Cincinnati would.
Inside for McDonald. It doesn't go. She had a really nice shot inside, and it wouldn't fall. Johnson gets a pass inside. Miller plus one.
And once again, UC just being very confident. Good passing. Only attacked because of obviously being a layup. They're controlling the tempo, even that, though that was a high percentage up-tempo shot right now. And right now, everything that the Pirates are trying to do right now, UC is obviously has an answer for.
And that was great passing by UC. You know, everybody kind of anticipated where the ball was going to be. It was great passing, great play there by UC. 70-57 now, 13-point lead. Bearcats' largest lead. Toure goes inside. The reverse doesn't go. Anna Owens brings it back up. Looks to go inside. Nothing there, so she'll pull it back out. And now UC can afford to kill the clock a little bit. Under 2 minutes now, and McDonald is called for the foul there on Shanice Johnson. So Johnson with 5 fouls there on the Pirates as a team. Shanice Johnson will go to the line. By the way, McDonald, that's her third foul. Really the only Pirate in any kind of foul trouble right now is Toure, and she has 4. Johnson had it in and out.
And right now, if you're coaching against UC and you look at the free throw percentage, that they're not having a good free throw shooting day today. So that was a good foul.
She misses two. That never happens. But as they have been struggling up the line, their percentage from the floor has been better than usual. And a quick timeout there by East Carolina. As East Carolina takes a 30-second break to kind of look at what's going on. So, again, we've got that 13-point lead. You know that McDonald's got 25 points, but you know she's going to be a target for UC's defense.
Absolutely, and Bannister from the three right now, because with it being a 13-point difference right now, they're going to need to look for a few three-pointers and then obviously jump right into the press. But this is a great timeout right now. No doubt that she's telling her team right now that they could still win this game. She wants them confident. She wants them to be fighters. We talked about her core values for this program now being hard work, being disciplined. I'm sure she's repeating those comments to them right now, because with a minute 48 right now, this is the kind of team that plays for 40 minutes right now. And you could tell by how hard they work. You could tell how she's meshing a lot of new players together, that they're playing this competitively at this point in the year. But right now, she's going to have to run a few more of those quick hits right now to get open opportunities.
Exactly. And it looks like they're trying to do exactly that. Toure with the scoop. Fight for the rebound. East Carolina gets it back. They're going to try it again. Outside, G, no. Rebound, UC. Zana Owens brings it back up now. Little pressure here in the corner. Doesn't look like East Carolina is going to foul right away, though, at all. As we come up on the one-minute mark here, as we wrap up this game, Quisenberry now pulling it back out, killing a little more time. Quisenberry tries to get it off. The shot, no. A little bit long there by Johnson. It goes right back to East Carolina with under a minute to go. McDonald kicks it out to Bannister. Bannister for three. Boy, Bannister has been really impressive, especially outside. So this is going to be a longer timeout as East Carolina calls another quick break. By the way, for Bannister, 11 points now so far in this game. Watch that outside shot. And we will take a quick break here. 51 seconds left in this contest. UC leads 70-60.
For every hero, there is an origin story. An experience that made them who they are. For a new generation of explorers, pioneers, and innovators, that experience is calling. Offering a different kind of education. One guided by distinguished professors who understand experience as the best teacher. Greatness lies beyond the classroom. This is where you start. University of Cincinnati. Do more.
When learning creates leaders, ideas are ignited, focus gets sharper, and service connects generations, we commit our expertise to heal, to discover, and to drive our region forward to a brighter tomorrow. East Carolina University. Tomorrow starts here.
We are back here at Fifth Third Arena for the final 51.4 seconds of this contest. Bearcats leading the Pirates 70-60. Backcourt pressure. Double team on Anna Owens. And they say that East Carolina touched it last, so it still belongs to UC. A few more seconds, 3 seconds ticking off, so now it's 48 seconds as Quisenberry gets ready to trigger it in. Gets it to Owens. McDonald on her now. She's able to bring it up. East Carolina looks content to just kind of let it run here for now. Double team over to Johnson. Johnson's looking for somebody to give it to. She gives it back to Owens. 6 seconds on the shot clock. Quisenberry goes inside. Wide open inside. Chelsea Warren. And that should do it for the Bearcats with less than 20 seconds to go. Touré out to McDonald. McDonald's been so impressive in this game as she takes it inside, gives it up. Nice pass inside there as Clater finishes it off. Quick foul there by G on Shanice Johnson. What a player. What a game for Shanice Johnson. What a game for Bree McDonald. Both of them really keeping their teams into this game. The Bearcats with a 10-point lead. 6.5 seconds to go as Shanice Johnson goes to the line. Her first one goes. As we mentioned early in this broadcast, Heather Macy, 5-0 against UC. Jamel Elliott has never defeated East Carolina. In fact, their last meeting was in the conference tournament last season. But this time with McDonald, the uncontested layup with 0.4 seconds to go, and that will do it. Here at Fifth Third Arena as the UC Bearcats remain undefeated in the month of January. Only one loss so far in the conference, and that one came on New Year's Eve at SMU. They've run the table so far, and UC defeats East Carolina 74-64. That means that they will be going on the road next week carrying that 5-1 record in the conference. They will be on the road, and then they will be coming back here next Saturday as UC off to its best start so far in the Jamel Elliott era, especially here in the conference. 5-1 now in the conference as East Carolina now falls to 1-6 in the conference. But as we said, East Carolina has had a tough, tough early schedule in the conference. They have played some of the top teams so far in the conference. So their start may be not indicative of the kind of game that they have. Let's throw it over to Maria Fantanarosa. She's here with our player of the game, Shanice Johnson.
Double-double, and my question to you is, how do you continue to finish in the fourth quarter with the confidence that you do?
My team, they keep me motivated, they keep me positive. At the end of the day, my team is the only thing that matters. My individual effort only is a contributor to the team goals.
Congratulations. Coach Elliott, can I grab you for one quick question?
Sure.
Your team finishes. They're very confident right now. How do you get them to continue to play both aggressively on defense, but have a lot of people contribute on offense?
Keep finding things we need to work on so that they can stay motivated to get better every day. That's the answer, you know. Continue to fine-tune and watch film and focus on things we did well and congratulate them and pat them on the butt, but continue to find things we need to get better at because, you know, every game we play is going to be a tough one, and I just want us to be mentally and physically prepared to play every game that we play.
Congratulations, Coach, and good luck.
Jamel Elliott remains undefeated in January as the Bearcats stand now at 5-1 in the conference. Johnson with 22 points in this game, but Bree McDonald keeping her team in it with 27 points, leading all scorers. UC wins 74-64 over East Carolina. For Maria Fantanarosa and our entire crew here, I'm Betsy Ross. Thank you for being with us today on the American Digital Network.